Okay, what about number four? We have Vistareel. Now notice they did the same type of thing. They've got the manufacturer Pfizer Laboratories division at the top, national drug code number beneath it, Vistareel, which is the trade name, hydroxyzine, Pamuate, that would be your generic name. This one is some kind of liquid because it says 25 milligrams per 5 milliliters. It is an oral suspension, and you have 120 milliliters in this container. They have a recommended storage on the left. They have usual daily dosage over on the right, and this actually has a little bit more information than our previous examples. So, what were you asked for here? You were asked for a trade name, Vistareel, the generic name, hydroxyzine pamuate, the form, which is an oral suspension. And in the oral suspension, you expect a dosage or strength of 25 milligrams for every 5 milliliters. You have a total of 120 milliliters in the bottle, and the usual dosage is for adults. You're told 1 to 4 teaspoons, 3 to 4 times a day. Children 6 years and over, 2 to 4 teaspoons daily in divided doses. And under 6 years old, 2 teaspoons daily in divided doses. And while this does have the usual dosage, again, your doctor or whoever's prescribing this medicine will probably adjust it and be a little bit more specific. All right, well, what about number five? Now, number five, it's a fairly long picture here. It says study the MAR in the following figure. Well, MAR represents Medical Administration Record. And so the type is a little bit small, but if you look closely, it's the year 2001, it's July, and we have the dates from the 18th to the 23rd. And we have a list over on the left of all the drugs given. We have isoproterenol, Procardia. Notice both of those start with capital letters, so those would be trade names. Indomethacin, Digoxin, those both are all lowercase, so they're generic. Diureal, trade name. Carafate, trade name. Beneath each one, you have the amount and the way you're supposed to give the medicine and then how often. So this is 15 milligrams of isoproterenol, sublingual, 3 times a day. Now, notice that that particular medicine was given at 9 a.m., at 1 p.m., and 5 p.m. It was given between the 18th and the 21st, but it was no longer given after the 21st, so there's a discontinued date as well, 7/21/01. So that's the last date it was given. And you can read through each one of these. Also, notice there are some abbreviations. These are initials. This is the person who gave the medicine. So somebody with initials JO gave it at 9 a.m. And somebody with the initials LA gave it at 1 and 5 p.m. If you scroll down to the bottom, you will see that JO is Jane Olson and LA is Leon Avalon. You will also notice there's a spot for allergies, but this particular patient didn't have any allergies. And you will also notice the space for the instructor, excuse me, this patient's name, Tyrell Johnson, his address, his doctor's name. You also have a date, his date of birth, maybe his religion, and then also his insurance. Now, what kind of things did they ask about this one? You were supposed to identify the drugs administered on July 18th, 2001. Well, there are four listed, actually five drugs listed out here. If you scroll back up, and I'll do this slowly, on July 18th, that's the first day listed, isoproterenol was given 3 times a day, Procardia was given 2 times a day, indomethacin twice a day, looks like digoxin was given once a day, and diureal was given once a day. So you would simply list out all the drugs on the 18th. Now, when they talk about the 20th, when you scroll back up and look at that one, there was an extra drug given, and I can kind of cheat right here and look. Carafate was another drug. Okay, it says on number three how many drugs were administered at 9 p.m. on July 20th. So I'll go back slowly with July 20th and look in this column for 9 p.m. And I'm seeing 9 a.m. on several of these. The only one I see is at the bottom, 9 p.m., that's Carafate. So that's the only drug given at 9 p.m. Which drugs were administered daily for 6 consecutive days? Now that's supposed to be digoxin and diureal. 6 consecutive days means 6 days in a row. Well, the only one that where that happened, and you can look at it very quickly, it's digoxin and diureal. They have initials and times for each time it was given. Who administered the indomethacin at 5 p.m. on July 20th? Well, July 20th, let's see, 5 p.m. I have isoproterenol, we got LA, and you have LA for Procardia, you have LA for indomethacin, and you have LA for Carafate. Now let's see if that was a particular drug. It said, who administered indomethacin? Well, let me go back up to indomethacin. At 5 p.m. was LA, so that's Leon Ablon. It says, identify the drug for which the patient received 0.25 milligrams. And properly read, that's 25 hundredths of a milligram. All right, 25 hundredths of a milligram, but 0.25 milligrams would have been digoxin. Okay, so remember on the left, you have the drug, how much, how often, and how it's supposed to be given. And the last thing you're asked on this question is how many doses of Carafate were received by Mr. Johnson on July 22nd. So July 22nd, Carafate, and notice the 22nd is the next to last day. Carafate had four times that it was administered, so you would answer the question with four. Okay, number six. It says study the physician's order sheet and answer your questions. Okay, well let's see. We've got a date of October 12, 2001. It was 6 a.m. We have the patient's information again. The time that the orders were noted. Who did it? The nurse was June Olson. And over in the middle, we have all our drugs. Now, be sure you can read this carefully. The first drug was declamycin, 300 milligrams by mouth every 6 hours. The second drug was vitamin C, 2 grams by mouth twice a day. The third drug was Inderol, 120 milligrams by mouth daily. The last drug takes up three lines. Esmolol, you get 500 milligrams in 500 milliliters of a 0.9% solution, NS, infused at a rate of 15 milliliters per hour. Now that's a lot of information for one drug. The thing that I want you to pay attention to right now is the 15 milliliters per hour. We'll talk about the abbreviation NS later, and also this percentage will come up later. Well, let's look. It says, what is the dose of declamycin? Well, declamycin was 300 milligrams. How many times a day do you administer vitamin C? Well, that's BID, so twice a day. It says, if the last dose of declamycin was given at 12 noon, at what time should you administer the next dose? Now, declamycin was every 6 hours, so if it was at noon, 6 hours later would be 6 p.m. How many milliliters of Esmolol will Mr. Sanchez receive in 60 minutes? Now that's why I wanted you to pay attention to 15 milliliters per hour. An hour is 60 minutes, so he will get 15 milliliters in an hour, which is the same thing as getting 15 milliliters in 60 minutes. Later on, I'll ask you how much will he get in 2 hours or 3 hours, etc. The last question, it says, what is the patient's date of admission? And you have that date noted in a couple places, 10-12-01. You have it also up here with the patient's information, 10-12-01, and also top left by the drugs, 10-12-01.